Prince Harry and Meghan Markle have been accused of wanting to be part of the Hollywood super-rich elite as they rake in millions from their lucrative media deals. The couple relocated from the UK to the US in early 2020 when they relinquished their roles as working members of the royal family. In September of that year, Harry and Meghan signed a bumper deal with online streaming giant Netflix, with reports suggesting it was worth an eye-watering $100 million, 82 million pounds. In 2021, the Duke and Duchess of Sussex reportedly made a whopping $25 million when signing an exclusive deal with Spotify for their Archwell audio podcast series. That same year, Harry announced a lucrative multi-book deal with Penguin Random House. Earlier this week, the prince set a record with his tell-all memoir Spare after the English-language version sold more than 1.4 million copies on its first day of publication. Niall Gardiner, a Washington-based foreign policy expert, believes Harry and Meghan are trying to build a dynasty in the U.S., generating as much wealth as possible and making full use of their royal titles. He told Express.co.uk, "Their strategy is twofold. For as long as possible, they want to maximize their royal titles and generate as much wealth as they possibly can while carrying those titles." Prince Harry and Meghan Markle want to be part of Hollywood's super-rich elite, it has been claimed. Image, Getty. Prince Harry and Meghan Markle signed lucrative deals with Netflix and Spotify. Image, Getty. They don't just want to be wealthy, they want to be super wealthy and part of the Hollywood super-rich elite. The second part of their strategy is they want to build some type of dynasty in America, and Meghan sees herself as some kind of future political leader. Building up a great deal of wealth, potentially worth hundreds of millions of dollars, is important for that goal. Meghan and Harry see themselves as part of the US ruling elite and they want to be a key part of that. Prince Harry and Meghan Markle currently live in Montecito, California. Image, Getty. Building up a big fortune is a huge part of this, hence the Netflix documentary series, the Spotify podcasts and the book deal. But in a bitter blow to Harry and Meghan, Mr. Gardiner believes the U.S. is now turning on the couple, with the American public now seeing them as endlessly whining Hollywood-style celebrities. He also claims this has been amplified following the global release of Harry's bombshell memoir and interviews in the U.S. to promote it, which has seen him launch a series of bombshell claims against the royal family. The foreign policy expert said, "There has been a significant amount of interest in the U.S. from what Harry has said, but not as much that perhaps was anticipated." Harry and Meghan appeared in their own six-part documentary series on Netflix. Image, Netflix. Prince Harry's book set a new record on its first day of publication. Image, Getty. While the passing of the Queen dominated the U.S. news networks for about 2 weeks, Harry's book and his relentless attacks against the royal family have received limited coverage in the U.S. Harry isn't a popular figure in America, and nor is Meghan Markle. The Queen was massively popular in the U.S., so Harry is increasingly seen as a negative and whining character in the U.S. The American public is starting to turn against both Harry and Meghan. Prince Harry and Meghan Markle, where do they live? Image, Express. Trending. Mr. Gardiner continued, "They are both now seen as endlessly whining Hollywood-style celebrities, and most Americans see through them for what they are." Harry was once a very popular figure in America, but now he has a narrow band of supporters among the liberal elites. Buckingham Palace has so far not publicly commented on any of the recent claims made by Harry and Meghan.